Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm back in HHP designing a vacation home for the lovely Isabelle today. She works incredibly hard and doesn't get out from behind the resident services desk that often, so I figured she needed a vacation home for her to completely tune out and switch off in her downtime. I absolutely love how it turned out, and I'm thrilled to share it with you. I've gone for a completely girly, over-the-top pink home for Isabelle. I figured that she doesn't actually get to show a lot of her personality at work when she's got Tom Nook right next to her, so she'd have a vacation home that really showcased some of the fun and free spirit she is away from work. So originally when I was putting down the layout of the house, I was trying to play around with creating a home that looked very similar to some of the other vacation homes that I've done in the past, and I didn't really want to do that. So I've tried to create a layout that is a little bit different and has the kitchen in the back corner of the home when I'd normally put it right at the front somewhere. So for the kitchen area, I tried to use some pink appliances to fill out the space and make it look as really girly as possible, but I was finding the pink tones were a little bit too strong within the refrigerator, so I ended up using white appliances instead to just make things fit that little bit better. Later, I decided to swap out the island counters to this kitchen island unit instead because I actually preferred how that looked and how I could sit bar stools next to it like they would be used by someone who was using this home. And then I worked on the main dining area, which is really simple in its decoration. It's just the large covered table with the wooden simple chairs that just have proper pink vibes to them, and I've added down the Hawaiian print rug because I love the bright, vivid colours that contrast nicely with the muted tones. I'd originally segmented off this back corner of the build as I was planning on putting an office there, but I figured Isabelle's not going to want to work while she's enjoying her time away in her vacation home. So she'd probably want a space that would just be used as a snug and a little bit of a reading corner for her. So originally I was planning to have this just be a separate enclosed room, but I found that it was just a little bit too cluttered and overwhelming with having the solid partition walls and the bookshelves in that space. It felt too small overall. So I took those out and replaced them with the wooden slatted ones. I liked how these slatted wooden partition walls worked instead because they had a little bit of space in there to let light into the area but also hide away the snug and make it seem like a really private and chill environment that Isabelle's to be in, which I really liked as part of this build. And once I was happy with the main placement of the furniture items in the snug, and I'd put down the wooden flooring rug to just separate that space out a little more, I added in a few decorations into the dining and kitchen area, just small little tabletop items to add a little bit more personality into that area. I then worked on the living area, which is quite small and contained in and of itself, even though it is a larger space. I wanted to use a bit more of a mishmash of furniture because you don't typically see furniture matching each other within normal homes. So I've used the Moroccan sofa in a pink variation, but I've paired that with a rattan chair in white, even though it has a blue seat cover and I would rather change this to pink. Please Nintendo in the future, let us colour these items as we'd like. I do like how it looks together, and it adds a little bit of a different tone to this space overall. I've also given Isabelle her obligatory pink cup of coffee so that she can enjoy her living space overall. I decided to try something different with the TV as well. Rather than having the TV on a low table or trying to fit a low table under a wall-mounted TV like I typically do, I've used the low island counters in this space. They don't exactly fit to where the wall is, but I kind of like that because it gave me space to use something else elsewhere. Because of how low they are, I was able to then put some items directly under the TV without the TV sitting too high on the wall. So this might be a little bit tongue-in-cheek. I've added down the Nintendo Switch AC version and a cute music player under the TV. I don't know. Is it a little bit on the nose to put Animal Crossing New Horizons in Animal Crossing New Horizons? You can let me know in the comments. And then I played around with some of the pillars to just separate out the space. I didn't want to add any more walls into the room because they just kind of closed it off and made it seem like it was a little bit more oppressive given how small the space was. but using them allowed me to segment out different areas of the room that would be used otherwise, so I then had a small area to set up an office space with a small white laptop and a chair with the gingham pattern. And then once I was happy with the placement of items around the room, I turned my attention to wall decoration. Again, I've kept it quite simple because, as we all know by now, I love my realism in HHP builds, so I've got light switches everywhere, I have my radiators, as is classic for me, but I've also added down some print works that I don't normally use because they don't fit in with a lot of the vibes in the HHP room. And then when I was happy with the downstairs, I then turned my attention to the upstairs. This is actually a smaller space than the downstairs area, and I was intentionally trying to create a smaller room. Originally, my plan was to do this as a one bedroom, one bathroom area, but I decided that I wanted to have a little bit more space to put down a little bit more of a hint of who Isabelle is when she's not working. So I've created instead a small single bedroom and a small bathroom that was part of that. There was space for one more room for me to create up here. Originally I was intending for this to be an office area or some kind of addition to the study, but I ended up turning it into the second bedroom. They are two different styles within these bedrooms, and I really like how they ended up looking overall. So for the first bedroom I worked on, this has the pink vibes that I have going on in the rest of the house, and this is what I see as Isabelle's bedroom. It is incredibly small. There's only space for a bed and a dresser unit, but I think this is more than enough for Isabelle overall, and it gives that hint of who she is with the pink gingham bedding and that pattern matching on the lampshade. I also added down a small ivory rug because I wanted there to be a little bit of a separation between the floor and the bed area, and this rug fit that quite nicely to the vibes overall. And for the second bedroom, what I did was use the ranch bedroom set. It turns out there was only space for two items of furniture in here, like Isabelle's bedroom. But instead of going down the route of trying to fit in a dresser unit, which would have looked a little bit weird and you wouldn't have been able to walk around, I used the wardrobe instead, which just filled out the space a little bit more but still gave a really clear distinction between the sleeping space and the living area. And the last thing that I worked on within the upstairs area was this small entrance area that was actually bigger than the two bedrooms combined, funny enough. I didn't know quite what I was going to do with this area. I didn't know if it was going to be a dressing area or some kind of extension to a snug. In the end, I decided to go with the latter and just create a small area that just had a chair and a floor lamp and the stair dresser. I found this item when I did flipping CJ's home and I absolutely loved how it looked, so I figured I'd put it in here because it just fit back with the modern aesthetic that had a little bit of traditional vibe that Isabelle seems to have in the rest of her home. And then wall-mounted items, again I'm going for realism here, so there's light switches, there's radiators. I did also decide to add in the glow-in-the-dark stickers with a mirror, because that allows me to have a mirror above the sink, which it still annoys me today that we don't have a mirror item that is just hung on the wall. Nintendo needs to fix that in the next game, I swear. It will make my life so much better. And that is the completed vacation home for Isabelle. I absolutely love all the pink and girly vibes. I think she'd really enjoy spending some time here to just decompress and get away from the stresses that she's put under running resident services. I absolutely love all the pink vibes here that perfectly encapsulates the fun-loving personality Isabelle has that she doesn't quite get to showcase at work. If you want to see another vacation home build, I would recommend you check out Flick and CJ's vacation home here, and I'll see you over there. Take care, everyone.